Hey everyone, and welcome to class. So today I'm going to be teaching a problem called twins. The general idea of this program is we want to take an input string and then output each that string, but have each character in the string repeated twice after itself. So I've drawn some examples up on the board here. So for example, the string cat would become CCAATT. So we're repeating the C twice, the A twice, and the T twice. It's important to note this is the output we want and not something like, say, cat, cat, or C-A-T, C-A-T. That's not the output we're looking for. So I've drawn some other example inputs and outputs up here on the board. For example, A-A would become A-A-A, and D-I-D would become D-D-I-I-D-D. Awesome. Does anyone have any questions right now about what we're trying to accomplish with this program? All right, great. So I'm gonna walk through one example in more detail then before we start writing any code. So just to go back to our original example, let's say we had cat as our input string. What I think we want to do with this program is loop or iterate through each character in this input, stopping at each character, and then we just want to basically pop that character out twice. So we pop the C out twice, the A out twice, and the T out twice. And basically, if this is our input, we want to throw each doubled character into an output. That's sort of like a picture of what the algorithm wants to do. Any questions? Great. Okay. So let's start writing some code then. The first thing I'm going to do is define an output variable. So I'm going to call it output. And that variable is going to be a string. So we'll just define it as an empty string right here. Great. I talked about iterating through each character in cat. Anyone know what Python structure I would use to iterate through all those characters? Great, yeah, a for loop. Okay, so we'll say for, and then I'm gonna call it car in input. Awesome. And I think it's important to name this variable car here. Conventions are important. This makes it very clear that this variable, the car, in our original example, it's gonna be C first, and then A first, and then T, each time as like a string of length one. It's gonna be a short string on every loop through this loop, or iteration through this loop. Awesome. So now, can anyone tell me what I might do inside this loop to finish our program? Okay, so I think that's a great suggestion. Yeah, what we wanna do is take output and then add car to it. And what we can do, we can just add car once, add this first C, and then do it again. Say output again equals plus equals car. So what this plus equals operator does, for anyone who doesn't know, is it takes output, it keeps what's already in it, and then it also adds on this variable here, this car. So for example, if I'm here in my program, I've already done the two C's, output plus equals car, well, the car is going to be this A, and it's going to take the A, right here, and add it to output once, and then add it to output again. So after that iteration of the loop, get CCAA. Awesome. So now the last thing I need to do to finish off this program is just return output, and we're finished. Awesome. So what questions do you guys have about that program? Okay, the last thing I'm going to show you then before I sign off is just a way to make this a little bit shorter and cleaner. So instead of saying output plus equals car twice, one thing you can do is I'm just going to cross out this one and say output plus equals car plus car. And I do the parentheses around it, you don't really need that. It's just to show that each time we iterate through this loop, we're going to take output and we're going to add this car just twice, all in the same line. And that's going to be a little bit cleaner way of writing this program. Awesome. Any last questions before I sign off? All right, we'll see you guys next week.